survey form screenwriting has taught me that I know nothing about what I'm getting into. Also, apparently Mozart and Salieri never knew each other in real life. Studies of Chinese traditions has taught me that my last day of freedom was a lie, an illusion. I had to prepare a presentation for day one. That combination of noises approximates how I felt about the whole ordeal. I know how to speak English. Germany in the age of globalization has taught me that there are a lot of other people at the school who study German, apparently. I had no idea, like, all of the past German classes I've taken have been with the same 5 people, so I just assumed that was it. Sign language through pop music has taught me that nothing makes me giddier than learning a new language. Probably. The fact that it's in conjunction with music probably has something to do with it. The fact that it's American Sign Language probably has a lot to do with it. My giddy, that is, my elation, as you might say. Also, this is language. It's a couple of L's having a little party. Syntax and discourse has taught me that there's something called T-bar. And T-bar has a friend called V-bar. They sound like disc jockeys. Oh man, what club would they DJ at? Is syntax a dumb name for a club? Should you like change the spelling of it to make it cooler? Syntax? That's terrible. Syntax? We'll work on it. We'll talk. Reason, passion, and cognition have taught me that I know very little about money and sports ball. How much was Michael Jackson's contract worth?
$10 million?
How many points did Michael Jordan score in his career?
1,000?
Basically, I underestimated everything. Hardcore. Also, I've learned that I've become more dedicated to procrastinating. It's only day 2 of the semester and I'm already making a video. Next video, ideally, will be a music one. I have something planned. I just need to, like, you know, sit down and take time and do the thing. Kind of requires effort, you know? Sorry, my background is so dreadfully boring today. I left my tripod adapter at home, so I can't, like, put the camera on the tripod and film. My usual wall is right there. In other news, my wall of postcards is complete.
I'd put one between every number, and I've already filled up all the spaces. Da-da-da-da.
My collection of foreign editions of John Green books is still growing. I don't know if I showed you this. It's a Chinese edition of Paper Towns. I think it's published in Taiwan, so it's traditional characters. I've most recently acquired this one, The Fault in Our Stars, in Russian. Someone mailed this to me.
I mean, I feel like at this point, I just have to keep going. I feel like I've committed to it.
Take care, mwah, blah, 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 blah.
No! No, I have to show you my kitties. Hold on. It was in my pocket the whole time. I'll show you just one. I have 7, but here's just one. Here's the... Yes. Yes, there he is in focus. His name is Felix. He travels around with me on my phone. And, ooh, I have a notification.
It's the cutest little kitty I could ever ask for, and he doesn't make me sneeze. And that's all I want.
Okay, I'll show you a couple others. Just the ones that I've named, though. I've only named 3 of them so far.
This is Lester. And on my computer, this is Miranda.
It's a step in my journey to becoming a crazy cat lady. Okay, I should actually go. Bye!